My doctor called and they were testing out an ultrasound machine, a special ultra high tech one. And so they needed a guinea pig. So I happily rushed to his office. At that point, the doctors and nurses noticed that he had some differences. And so we knew we were dealing with something rare. We just would lay in bed and cry. And there were just so many unknowns. And our biggest fear, of course, was would he live? Is this something fatal? Yes, he was born with differences, but so what? He was born. There's something about your child, born missing feet, who walks. And he was 15 months old, and he took those steps, and I threw a party that night.
He is an amazing kid, and fun to watch. His joy, his energy, his approach to life is infectious. And so being around him, especially as his friend and a pediatrician, is a privilege.
We had ultrasound. The doctor saw just something minor that was a little bit different. And I remember my specialist sat me down one day and he said, I think you need to prepare to lose your daughter.
The worries about Ellie was would she make it or not? And if she made it, how long? And now to see this smiling, happy kid who's working really hard in therapy is really a joy for me. So it's been fun to take care of her and watch her grow. And her future is bright just because I know she has the support she needs.
If you would have talked to us 4 months before Will was born, I think we were looking at things as limitations. And I think we were looking at things that I don't know how we're going to do this or how we're going to get by and that type. And that's not to say that it isn't a challenge, that things aren't difficult at times and things aren't sometimes overwhelming to us. But at the same point in time, I think we are constantly amazed with both of our children with what abilities they have and what they can do and what they can do just to think of a new way to be able to accomplish something or to think of a new way to solve a problem that they're faced with. And it just always amazes us.
We've had the special needs clinic in operation for 17 years, and at the beginning it was a novel approach to consider paying a salary rather than buying a piece of equipment, but it's been money well spent, and the nurses that work for these kids have been, I think, the best investment that Children's Miracle Network has made in East Texas.
Honestly, I don't think I really understood what Children's Miracle Network was until I moved here and I got the idea of the special needs clinic, and slowly I started learning things that, oh, this is available to all children for any typical reason ends up in the hospital and you need specialized pediatric equipment so that you may not have to go to Dallas to get it. You can have it right here locally. So I think that's been a huge revelation to us, is the far-reaching impact that it can have on all kids in East Texas to have that here locally.
Because everybody's looking for miracles, 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 and a miracle is happening tonight. I'm gonna take it slow, back on the street. I'm gonna take my time. Now I'm back on my feet. And all that we ever do, we do. Your mother must fight just to keep them alive. That's only advice.
Tell me, baby,
baby, I've been around the world.
take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Say they all add up. I live.